Hello, I'm Mike. Would you like incredible AI images featuring your face like this, 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 and this? Well, this video guide will show you exactly how to create your own AI model that features your own face or that of anyone you like, really. And best of all, it's surprisingly quick, easy, and budget-friendly, even pretty much free to start with. Just follow the steps in this video, and you'll be done. By the end of the video, I'll even have a fancy automation so you can generate those images whenever you like using Slack or another tool that you use every day. Just imagine generating an unlimited amount of unique images featuring yourself in any situation, at any scene, at any time, using just a simple AI prompt. Let's dive in. To start with, you'll need to access this AI training model that uses H100 chips from NVIDIA. Now, don't get worried when I say that, because this is going to take about 20 minutes to train, and the compute power is less than $2. So if you can afford $2, you can do this. Next up, you'll want 12 to 20 really nice photos of yourself in all kinds of different weird situations, some recent, some not so recent. And it helps if you have variety, no shadows, and clear facial features. Now, I've actually got 22 images here. It doesn't really change anything, just means I pay more for compute power. So I might pay $2.01, for instance. Then we just right-click and make sure to compress on the Mac or use your favorite compression software on Windows. I've now got archive.zip right here, ready to use. So now with that done, we go to this Flux Dev LoRA trainer, and of course I'll link this up down below. And it's as simple as filling out a form to get started. Now, first of all, we need to select a destination. I'm going to create a new model. This will be personal to me, and this is what I'll use to generate AI images with my face. So I'm calling it AI Mike Images, and I'm making it private to me. I suggest you do the same. Then here under Input Images, this is where you add your zip file. Archive.zip comes there, drag and drop. It's as simple as that. It's done. Now, what is the trigger word? The trigger word, that sounds so sinister, but really it's just got to be a unique word that you can use to trigger images with your face. Now, if you use a common word, you might confuse the AI, so make sure to use something unique here. In this example, I'm going to use M-I-K-R, Miker. That's not a very common word, and whenever I use that word, the AI will generate images with my face. It really is as simple as those three things. Select a destination, upload your zip file containing images of your face, and use a trigger word. Now we'll just gloss over this. We can just untick this. We won't be using auto caption. Steps, yep, 1000 is a good starting point. That's what I'd recommend. Leave everything else pretty much as default. You can use Hugging Face tokens if you also want to host this on Hugging Face, and you know what that is, then that's absolutely fine. But everything else is fine. So now to get started, we click Create Training, and boom, you'll see that it's now running over here, and we're going to see logs go through and update. We can actually make them full screen so we can watch this training in action. Now, it is going to take about 20 minutes, so I think I'll go off and have a quick cup of tea, and I'll come back when this model is fully trained and we can try it out. Okay, cup of tea made. And that actually only took around 11 minutes. So there is all the training. Look at all of that training that's occurred. And of course, we can tell it's good because it says up here, succeeded. Okay, this is great. And we'll see AI Mike Images is ready to go on its latest version. The trigger word is Mica, and it makes that clear. So let's just try this out with Mica looking happy on the beach. That's all we need to type, just the prompt, nothing else, and then click run. Oh my goodness. Yes, a lot less hair and rather less clothes as well. Okay, I'm a little bit scared now. Mica looking happy, sunbathing on the beach with hair. Here we go. And oh, yeah, okay. Yeah. Just Mica in a cyberpunk world. And here we go. It's running through the image generation trained on all of my facial data set there. Oh my goodness, he looks so seriously. And he's cracking knuckles there as well, it seems, or at least merging fingers. And if we want to make this YouTube thumbnail style, you'll see here in Replicate, we've got all these options like aspect ratio, which obviously is important. So 16:9 will be perfect for YouTube. We can change the height and width if we want. We can actually really go into detail. We can even change the model of Flux that we're using to generate the image, but that should be enough. Let's run it with that prompt. And in just a moment, whoa. Okay, for some reason, it really doesn't like putting clothes on me. The banana looks more scared than I do. I look like I'm actually enjoying that scenario. But there you go. You get the idea. Yeah, I don't quite know what to say about that. Always wearing no clothes in a tropical paradise. Let's try with clothes. How about Secret Agent Micah jumping away from an explosion without looking back? Nice action shot. Another nice one to download. Oh my goodness. All right, let's do this one. Micah with a lightsaber facing off against Darth Vader. Will it bring in well-known movie characters? And yes, it seems it will. Let's double down on that and put me in the Matrix. Neo, eat your heart out. It's Mike in the Matrix. Now you're probably wondering, how much does it cost to generate these images? Well, I'm pleased to say it's between 2 and 3 cents per generation. Okay, let's try this one. Renaissance painting of Royal Micah with a tiny crown. Yes, 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 it's always the person I thought I could be. Yes! Here's another one. I'm a cowboy in the Wild West, but I'm afraid of horses. And yeah, I don't look too confident there. Next up, world famous chef creating a kitchen disaster. There we go. Rockstar Mike mid-guitar solo with the most intense face ever. Maybe, maybe, possibly. How about Olympic athlete Mike breaking the world record? Okay, yeah, not too bad. Although I'm not sure what's going on with the name badge. Probably the less said about that, the better. Now we can, of course, increase the number of outputs. We can get 4 outputs. Here we go. Well, that one's scary. That one's also scary. That one is mysterious. And this one is just weird. So I guess the better prompt you give, the better output you get. Now, it's all very well if you wanted to train AI on your face and make AI images using your own face. You've done it. I've given you all the tools and the way to make it happen, and within minutes you can be doing it. But if you want to get advanced, I'm going to show you how to set up a workflow now. But if you want to get advanced, stick around and also throw a like and subscribe to my channel for more videos just like this one. So in this case now, we're going to take what we've learned here inside Replicate and put it into a Zapier workflow that's going to work inside Slack. So at any time, I can go to a channel, type in what I want, and get the images back in something that I use every single day. It could be Slack, it could be Discord, or anything that you're using to work in daily. Okay, so first of all, here we are inside Zapier, and I'm going to create a brand new Zap. Now with this, the trigger, we want it to be something that comes from Slack. So I'll type in Slack here, and then select it. And you can see my account is already linked here as Mike at Creator Magic. For the trigger event, we're going to choose New Message Posted to Channel. But first, we need to create that channel. So over here in my Slack, I'll just add a channel and it'll be a brand new channel. And let's go ahead and click next to a blank channel. We'll call it AI Image Gen. So now when we select New Message Posted to Channel, we can go ahead and configure it. And then we'll drop down and you should see here AI Image Gen appears as an option here. Obviously, we want trigger for bot messages, no, and we'll leave optimized data off as well. But let's type in a message and see if it works. And boom, it's pulled in the message. And if we scroll down, we'll actually see that the text indeed is hello. So now we've got the message from Slack to Zapier. We can use Zapier to pass it on to our AI image generator and eventually give us some images back. As the next action, I'm going to use AI by Zapier. And this will essentially take whatever I've typed into my Slack channel and enhance it so that I've got an enhanced prompt to send off to my AI image generator. Now it's taken me into Prompt Builder. It's really nice that Zapier assists you with making prompts. And here, as the desired action, I've said, I would like a prompt to enhance the input given and generate a prompt for an AI image generator that makes images containing my face when the trigger word MicR is included in the prompt. Okay, and look at that. In one shot, it's generated a prompt that says you're a master of AI image prompt engineering. It's given the prompt from my Slack channel. It gives some guidelines. It says use the MicR trigger word, and it gives an input and output example. This is really cool. So Zapier AI will take whatever I type into Slack, enhance it, and send it off for generation. Let's continue, and let's test the step with the word hello. And actually, it's done really well as the output. It says a warm and inviting scene featuring a cozy room with soft ambient lighting. There's an armchair and MicR there with expressive eyes and a gentle smile. Okay, on we go. And this time we're going to add in a webhook, and this will be our ability to call the AI model we just trained and make the images. So we're going to go for a custom request. I'm going to insert the URL. Now, don't worry about this bit. I will post a link to my community where I'll put the exact details of what I've put in this step so you can copy it too. Data pass through will be false. So I'll add in all the lovely data here. And essentially, it's the version of the AI model I created on Replicate. I'm using the Flux dev version. Now the prompt, we're going to put a forward slash and we're going to actually insert the output from our Zapier AI there. Then for headers, we'll put authorization, bearer right here, and then my API key. Also got the content type as application/JSON, and then prefer as weight. Let's continue. Okay, this webhook is pretty much set up, so let's test it and see if it works. Now, of course, this is going to take a little moment because it's actually running right now, and it seems to be done. Look at this. So it's called the model Mike AI Images. Yes, that's correct. Everything is looking good here. And the most important thing, we can see we've got four different outputs, the URLs here as JPEG files. Now, to save on costs, I might actually take my request down to just one image per go. And to do that, we just need to edit the webhook and, of course, edit what we've configured here. Everything is configurable, so I can change number of outputs to one. And we simply add one more step, and that, of course, is going to be Slack once more. And this time we're going to send a channel message. It's really easy to set up. Select the channel. Of course, it will be the same AI image gen again, so selecting that one. And do we want to add Zapier app to channels automatically? We'll say yes. And for the message text, well, we don't need to do anything else apart from placing the URL of the generated image. And we'll see this will appear under our custom request in webhooks. And there is the output URL. And once that's done, we can send it as a bot. This is all absolutely fine. And we can choose to customize this however we want. So I'm going to switch off the link there. Auto expanded links, yes. Link to usernames and channel names, all good. No need to schedule or anything like that. Continue, let's give it a test. And boom, yes, not only has it given me the URL here, but it's given me a preview of the image that I can pop open. So if I type as an airline pilot, step by step, this pulls back in. We'll continue with that selected record for this example. We'll let the AI generate a prompt. We'll then call our AI image generator. And then we'll continue to the Slack message where we retest, go back to Slack, and boom, there it is. Mike Russell has the airline pilot straight inside my Slack channel. That is really, really cool. So we're obviously happy with this now, so we can actually publish this app, which we'll put it live. So let's do that. That means anytime I type something into my Slack channel that I've designated as my AI image gen channel, it'll make an image of me. Let's have some fun. Baked beans. Okay, that's given me just baked beans back, but I guess I did ask for baked beans. Yeah, nice. Now I've typed in the word cowboy here. Boom, yep, there's Mike Cowboy. I quite like that look. Here it comes. Yep, it's Mike as a rather scary rock star. Triathlete. And here comes Mike the triathlete. Really giving it some there on that small, slim road bike. Okay, business person. Here it comes. Hey, smart, looking good. Yes, I'd hire myself. Doctor. Well, you really can't argue with Dr. Mike. And the classic for this channel, wizard. Here it comes. Yes, Mike the wizard. That could almost be the thumbnail for this video. So you're probably wondering, how much did this all cost? So I'm going to show you my replicate billing page so you can decide for yourself. Now, first of all, you'll see this down here. This was how much it cost to train my AI model with those 22 images of me. $1.10. That's all it cost. 722 seconds usage of an NVIDIA H100 GPU. Now, this $1.54 is what I've spent on generating tons of AI Mike images. Yes, I've used this GPU a lot. I have generated hundreds, maybe even to the thousands of images for this video, and you've only seen a select few, so I count that as really good. You can see before I got started, I generated using a bad 70s food custom AI model, and it cost me just 2 cents to generate one image. So really, you're looking at under $2 to train your face into AI and then around 2 cents per image. That's pretty good in my book. If you like that, throw a like on this video and subscribe for more stuff just like this. Thank you so much for watching this video. I really can't wait to see what you go out and create, possibly using your own face, using Slack and other automations. And the best thing is, my images got better towards the end because Zapier's own AI was enhancing my prompt before passing it to my custom AI model that's trained on my face. Pretty cool stuff, isn't it? Thanks so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen right now that you should watch next. Thanks.